What kind of impact can a mission school have on a family? Shema, which means mother in the Navajo language, heard about Hallbrook Seventh-day Adventist Indian School about 40 years ago. An elderly friend spoke very highly of Hallbrook Seventh-day Adventist Indian School, located on the Navajo Reservation in the U.S. state of Arizona. "The school provides an excellent education to our Navajo children," he said. Shima listened carefully because she very much respected her friend. He had worked as a code talker for the U.S. military using the little-known Navajo language as a means of secret communications during wartime. Shima enrolled 5 of her 7 children at Hallbrook Seventh-day Adventist Indian School. Her eldest son learned how to weld and do other metalwork at Hallbrook Seventh-day Adventist Indian School. He loved working with metal and became a metal worker. Shima's second eldest child, a girl, decided to go to an Adventist college after graduating from Hallbrook Seventh-day Adventist Indian School. She studied nursing at Pacific Union College in California and works today as a nurse on the Navajo Reservation. Shima did not send her 2 youngest children to Hallbrook Seventh-day Adventist Indian School. She decided not to send them because she became unhappy with the school. One of her daughters, Naba, had some difficulties at the school, and the school ended up asking her to leave. Shima felt hurt that her daughter was not allowed to stay. It turned out, however, that Naba not only had difficulties at Hallbrook Seventh-day Adventist Indian School, but she also had difficulties at every school she attended. She eventually graduated from another school, where she lived with a Christian family and went on to college, and became a teacher. Naba is still teaching and is a member of the Seventh-day Adventist Church today. Naba must have forgiven Hallbrook Seventh-day Adventist Indian School for dismissing her because she enrolled all 3 of her children at the school. Naba's children, who are young adults, have graduated from Hallbrook and are doing well. One is a teacher, another is about to become a teacher, the 3rd child is a wife of an Adventist pastor and is starting to become a teacher too. Whatever happened to Shima's 2 youngest children who never went to Hallbrook? They learned about Jesus from their family members and both became Seventh-day Adventists. One of them teaches at an Adventist school today. What kind of impact can a mission school have on a family? Hallbrook Seventh-day Adventist Indian School has had a major impact on Shima's family and many others on the Navajo Reservation and beyond. Thank you for your 13th Sabbath offering 3 years ago that kickstarted plans on a new gym and health center called New Life Center at Hallbrook Seventh-day Adventist Indian School. Your offering this quarter will help finish the second phase of the center, where the school will address high rates of obesity, heart disease, diabetes, depression, and suicide among Native American children and youth. Thank you guys for watching. Please smash the subscribe button, ring the notification bell, and turn the like button to blue.